Welcome back, all of you, to the next day's program on efficient procurement implementation. We are into costing, and then we have completed the costing setups. It's a very tough part. Try to concentrate a lot and then try to understand it fully. Now we are into costing transactions. So let me go and I will now start the activity now. So it's slightly different when compared to EBIS now. In EBIS, what happens, costing transactions are perpetual. That is, as and when the transactions take place in the inventory, what happens, the costing is also done. So, for example, if you make a receipt to the gate, fine, I'm going to make a receipt to the gate. What happens? The receiving inspection is it. The contra entry is accrual. That gets automatically hit. And then afterwards, what happens when you deliver it? What happens? You'll be seeing that what happens? The inventory material value will be hit. That is known as an inventory valuation. And then the purchase price variance, if it is a standard costing, that will be hit. And then what happens? The receiving inspection account gets knocked off. So, I'll go on and show it, you know, fine, go there. So I will now go to the inventory transactions, metal transactions, and then let me go and have a look at it now. Fine. Go there and click on find now. So let us take one of the items which have been received as a purchase order receipt, actually. Fine, PO receipt, I'm showing it to you. Fine, go there, this line. If you go and then click on the distributions now. Now here what happens, distributions are getting automatically created. That where happens, we have to create the distributions manually. We have to create the distributions. Here, the distributions are perpetual now. So as and when the transactions take place, whatever the distributions will be taking place. Here in Fusion, it is not so. We only have to get the distributions. We can even schedule the concurrents. So by which whatever the distribution get created. So I click on the distributions now. Here, go there and then see this now. If you go to the type, you can now see the PPV is it, the inventory valuation is it, the receiving inspection is it. Fine. The PPV will come only when what happens, there is a standard costing. Otherwise, what happens, it will not be hit. You can now see this one, this one. If you go on and have a look at it now, fine. So the PPV will hit only for the standard costing organization. For average costing organization, will not be hit now. So as far as financial accounting is concerned, this is called inventory valuation. Fine. This is called inventory valuation. And then in PO, we have seen the charge account. There are six many ways of charging the charge account. Fine. The asset charging, expense charging, etc., etc. So when you are transacting asset into expense, expense into asset, etc., etc., what happens? There will be different charge accounts. So why they need multiple charge accounts is what? Against which account, what, how much has been spent actually. Right? Only for spend analysis, they need multiple accounts. So by looking at the PO charge account, they will automatically understand that what happens this month, how much they have spent on which account. Then afterwards, what happens, they will be communicating with the management, and so what happens, the spend reduction process will start to take place. But as far as financial accounting is concerned, you will have multiple accounts at the what happens, your category level override accounts, everything will be having. But what happens, it has to get a common account. So inventory valuation is a common account for all the purchase order receipts actually. Fine. So this is for financial accounting. That is for purchasing accounting. Remember, fine. That is for purchasing accounting. Charge account is for purchasing accounting. And then the inventory valuation is for financial accounting. Fine. So this is what is. So there will be only one common account. And I have not yet specified the inventory valuation as well as receiving inspection account. Because for financial accounting, I'm not done. So what happens when I perform the credit accounting, it will not fail. It will not show me these things. Fine. It will not say this is missing, this is missing. So I'm yet to specify it now. Fine. So as far as financial accounting is concerned, what happens? We have to have a receiving inspection account. We have to have an accrual account. And then since I'm transacting only on asset accrual, whatever I have given it, but expense accrual also I have said it, but obviously I'm not going to use it now. Fine. So we have to have asset accrual and expense accrual. Then inventory valuation, which is not yet set now. And then what happens? The PPV I'm not going to have because we are not working on an average costing organization. Then the receiving inspection, fine. So the receiving inspection and inventory valuation is not yet set in the financial accounting. Fine. Afterwards, the remaining accounts are set. Fine. Accrual is there. The liability is there. Fine. Everything is now set. Fine. So other accounts are okay as far as the PTP lifecycle is concerned. So, but what happens as far as the PTP lifecycle is concerned, two more accounts are required. One is what? Receiving inspection as well as inventory valuation. So inventory valuation is a common account which will be hit once when you perform delivery of the item into the inventory now. Fine. When you perform a receipt into the inventory, what happens? These two accounts will be hit. The receiving inspection to accrual. And then when you deliver it, what happens? These two accounts will be hit. Right? Inventory valuation to receiving inspection. Right? Got it? So any doubts on this process?
Nana, there would be another account. Supplier account would also hit when you... Supplier? That would be debit. Supplier.
Supplier account. What is that account? There is no such account at all here.
No, there is no account. I mean, here it's not listed, but when you actually bring the inventory, right? That time, inventory valuation.
What is the supplier means? You should not say simply supplier account. There must be some name for this. I don't know what exactly the name you're saying. These are all the PTP accounts as far as purchasing is concerned. Every model will be having its own account. Every model will be having its own account. So, for example, when I make what happens, what's called, this is for the purchase order zips now. fine, let us say I will now go and then what happens, a sports bag, let us say fine, a PC cabinet, I'm going to manufacture it now. When I'm manufacturing it, what happens, if you click on the distributions, you'll be having what? The WIP valuation will be getting, what happens, will be relieved, and then the inventory valuation gets charged. Right? For each and every module, there will be a pair of accounts. What happens, you'll be having all the accounts to be set for each and every module. Even for inventory also, what happens, you'll be having intro transfers, and then the move orders, the whatever subunity transfers, everything will be having a respective accounts. So those accounts have to be set. So since we are concentrating only on purchasing, what happens, this is the only accounts which are required for purchasing. Okay, fine. So you must understand the concept of charge account as well as valuation account. That is why what happens, I am not dealing again and again. Fine. The valuation account will come into picture. Because financial accounting will now count everything on only on one account, whereas charge account will be on multiple accounts. There may be even hundreds of accounts. Fine. Based on each and every category, you'll be having a different charge account. That is for spend analysis, basically. And then when you perform a delivery, it will be hitting a common account. It will be hitting a common account. Good. So afterwards, what happens, we go there. We'll not see this now. Fine. There are 12 setups I told you. Out of these setups for this training exercise, what happens? 1, 6, 7, 8, and 10, you need not have to do. Fine. Again, I will repeat now. Please take a note of it now. Fine. 1, 6, 7, 8, and then 10, we need not have to do. The remaining you have to do for this training. In reality, what happens when you go to the field, client's location, you have to do all the 12 setups. In the client's location, you have to do all the setups. Whereas here, what happens in this training, one is not required. Fine. Of course, in the client's location also, you'll not do one as such. Now, fine. 1, 6, 7, and 8. What happens? I have already set it up, so no need for it to do it. 10th also, I have already done it. Right? 6, 7, 8, and 10, I have already done, so no need to do at all. So in the client's location, what happens? 1, apart from 1, 2 to 12, you have to do everything. Is it clear now? So here, 1, 6, 7, 8, and 10 need not be done. The remaining setups here. Good. Then we'll now go on. Then go ahead on this now. So you understood the difference between the charge account as well as the inventory valuation account. Fine. Go there. So we are not given what these two accounts now. Fine. Then my credit accounting is going to fail because receiving inspection is not given, as well as what happens, your inventory valuation is not given. So when I perform a credit accounting on both the places, what happens, it will be failing. Whereas in eBiz, it is not so. Fine. The accounts are getting auto-populated as and when you perform the transactions. And then afterwards, when you close the inventory period, what happens, they are all pushed into pushed through SLA into GL for financial accounting. Fine. There is no need. But in fact, what happens in Fusion, there is no periods at all in supply chain. And so what happens, we have to push everything to costing. And then in the costing, we will not create the distribution. Distributions are created only in costing. The accounting distributions are created only in costing. It's beautifully done. So the supply chain team need not have to worry at all anything. Fine. So they will not do everything for you. Any doubts on this now? It's a very tough topic. It is not an easy one. You have to sit and then what happens, listen, and then you have to understand it. Whatever I say, there will be some salient points that are told. What happens, you have to, what happens, sit and then do it now. Because I was involved in the all the accounting part also in my, what happens, in my career. Even though I'm not directly involved, what happens, I used to solve many issues in the accounting. Because what happens, some people make some mistake on this account, and then what happens, it will be, they used to reverse the accounts, you know, reverse the journals in GL. They will not be scolding the supply chain guys like anything. I'm asking one account, they put some other account. Mainly because what happens in the field, there will be unpaid ATMIs, and then what happens, they'll be populating a wrong account. And then these guys at the month end, what happens, they'll be having a very heavy work. And then even the supply chain team also will be sitting along with them to what happens, reverse all the accounts, because they will help each another. So that happens in this thing. That's why they thought that very nicely, what happens, don't do any accounting in a supply chain at all. Fine, we will do it. We'll take care of it. So they set up everything and then they will now take care of everything. So there is no, what happens, dependency on the supply chain team at all as far as what happens, financial accounting is concerned. So let us go there and then let us now create a new item now and then start our activity on this. We have done a lot of exercise. Month end means what? It will be a heavy job for everybody, actually, including financials and supply chain. Every team will be basically busy as one their activities. We go there. Click on it and then go there. Click on sign in now. I'm not going to sign in. And then let me create a new item and then for performing the cost accounting. And go there. So click on this and then go to the product management. You go to the product management and then go to the product information management. And then now what happens? You're going to create a new item. Go there, click on it, and click on create item. So let me get a new item for cost, just now, fine. So it's M10-0. I'm putting this cost up. And go there. It's a root item class. I put the wrong, correct organization. No? One second. I have made a note. M100 2 AUGS came actually. Okay, somebody has made this also. Okay, fine, this is my organization. Okay, fine, go there. I know whether it's fine. Go there, go down, and then click on this now. And then click on this purchase template and then bring it to the right hand side. And then click on OK by which form the replate is applied. And then item is M10 underscore cost underscore test is the item. Fine. I will not say it is a cost test item. Fine, go there. And then go down. And then I will click on the specifications and I'll see the list price now. Go there. Click and have a look at the list price. So go to the purchasing and then have a look at the list price now. So list price is 2. And then I'm going to override the purchase order. This gets defaulted into the requisitions and purchase orders. That is, I'm going to override now. And go there. And then since the costing profile is set to auto, what happens? This item will be enabled for costing actually. Fine. The costing profile has to be set to auto. There is a default cost profile which you are given for the asset and expense item. So that has to be what happens auto. So then what happens at the beginning? Associated automatically. Fine. Click on the associations. Go through the document. It will be giving you a lot of theory now. Fine. That you have to learn. Sit and learn actually. Go to select NAT. Fine. Go there. I will now put my child organization. Fine. 101 as an entry. Even though it's not your cup of tea, what happens? If you know this, what happens? All the girls will be behind you. Go there. Fine. What happens? They have not done it. M100 and then M101. Fine, go there. I will now click on save and close by which what happens. M10 underscore cost underscore test is now created. And then let us go on and get a purchase order. Directly. Item is created. So let us go on and get a purchase order for 10 quantities. 100 quantities now. Fine, go there. Click on it now. And then go to the procurement. Go to the procurement. And then here, what happens? I go to the purchasing. And then I am going to get a purchase order. Remember, we are seeing only the purchasing accounting. Fine. The inventory accounting has to be sent. Everything will be done by the financials, basically. Fine. The manufacturing accounting, and then your projects accounting. There are so many accountings out there, basically. And then the payables accounting, the receivables accounting, everything they will not set as such. Go there. I will now make it fine. M10. And then let me put the supplier over here now. Fine. Sub 1. And then click on create now. I'm going to get a PO now. So let me make it as a direct delivery so that what happens, both the transactions will be done in one go. Fine. When you perform a receipt, what happens, the receive as well as the deliver transactions are completed in one go actually. And again, no accounting. Fine. So the receive and deliver will be done in one go. And go there, go inside now. So we are now going to create a purchase order now. So we'll now make the receipt routing as direct. And then we will now override the PO price from 2 to 1 now. Fine. Whatever is there in the item, what happens, it will be getting defaulted over here now. And then that can be overridden to any value, whatever you want now. So we are going to override it now. And then that is the reason that what happens, the list price is what happens, has been discussed during Hyder Ali period. And so what happens, it cannot be used for the, what happens, the CPA route for automation actually. So no company will use it. It is true for any ERP. So many companies will be having a contract purchase agreement as well as a blanket purchase agreement in a different form basically. So the contract purchase agreement is mainly for what, if a supplier is a very renowned supplier, is supplying many, many products, what happens, we discuss with him the terms. So the terms are basically negotiated with which what happens, it will be going ahead on this now. And then afterwards, what happens, we can negotiate the price and then what happens, we can populate our purchase orders. Basically. I don't know why it's taking a long time.
Nana, while you do this, I have a quick question.
Tell me.
But so far, still you didn't, yesterday I was asking one question, right? And well, now also you started doing the transactions, but you did not give any... the variation accounts or anything like
that.
Like,
I just told you, 1 minute. I just told you that for what happens, your financial accounting, we need the receiving inspection account, we need the accrual account, we need the valuation account, we need the liability account. Fine. So we have now provided the IPV also, invoice price variance accounts. So we have provided the liability account, we have provided the IPV account, and then we have not provided the valuation as well as receiving inspection account. These two accounts are still missing. And so what happens, your accounting will not take place. I'll show you. Fine.
Okay.
So for a P2P accounting, what happens? We need the receiving inspection account. We need the AP accrual account. We need the valuation account, inventory valuation account. We need the IPV account as well as the liability account. These 5 accounts are very, very important now for the P2P lifecycle. Out of which 3 accounts we are given. Fine. We are now given what? The liability we are given. The accrual we have given now. Fine. The IPV also we are given. But we are not given the receiving inspection as well as what happens? We are not given the valuation. Inventory valuation. So,
intentionally, you were trying to fail it. That's what. Intentionally, you are trying to fail the.
Yeah, intentionally, I'm trying to fail, of course. Intentionally, I'm trying to fail, of course. So then what happens? You can understand that exactly is failing, actually.
Okay. And also, like, you know, the material overheads also, right? I mean, that also can.
Material overhead and all will be coming in manufacturing, basically.
No, it can. Like, if there is a. You know, there, for the buy items also, there can be.
There cannot be any material overhead at all. In the purchasing, we don't have any material overhead at all. I told you, na, purchasing is going to push only 5 components into the costing module. Yesterday, I told you. Fine, those components only will be coming now. Fine, go there. I'll not show it to you again. Fine. Nothing else will come from purchasing at all. Fine, no middle overhead, nothing. I'll again tell you. Fine, I'll now go to the what's called cost.
No, for the buy items also, it can have the material overheads, right?
Like, no way, happened. No way. Purchase orders will only give you the exchange rate variance. Item price, invoice price variance, freight, and non-recoverable tax. These are the only components which are going to flow into the costing module from purchasing. No other things. Nothing else flows. And then only for this, what happens? We have to have a corresponding cost element now. No material overhead at all in purchasing. In EV is also where exactly the material overhead comes into picture. As far as PO is concerned.
You can actually. Like, like you can define the, like, you know, the absorption rules. Okay, like if there is a predefined
rule, will be always on the manufacturing side only. Absorption is a contra entry for the middle overhead. Fine, that will be coming only on manufacturing, nowhere else. In the purchase P2P life cycle, the middle overhead will never come into picture. You may map it to something like a middle overhead, some components of it, but what happens? It is normally not done. Everything will be mapped only middle. I never seen. Maybe you might have seen it something, like, but I have not seen it wrong.
No, I mean, I just wanted to understand that kind of the placeholder where we define it all.
No, here it is not so at all. Fine, you don't have any such what happens. Material overhead cannot be defined at all in purchasing. You cannot do it. Go there now. Again, open up another one. Fine, go there. Go to the procurement now. Click on the procurement, and then go to the purchasing.
I think Pradeep, you are talking about all these things, right? Which are just shown, right? So those are the part of material overhead. So I think it depends on like how you are defining and structuring them, right?
No, it depends upon, like, you know, how, you know, not only map it, like, you know, say for example, if there is a, the freight charges, okay, and if for the buy items especially.
Yeah, right? Freight charges can be, you can map it, as you see, as you're saying. Here in this case, what happens? You're going to map the freight charges, which is now coming to a middle overhead. Okay, fine.
Right.
What happens? It can be done. Your freight can be mapped to a middle overhead. Then what happens? It will be a middle overhead. So that is only for our internal thing. But from the PO side, what happens? There is no middle overhead which is coming. The freight may come. The freight may be mapped to your internal middle overhead component, actually. That can be done.
Right. That's fine. I just wanted to understand the kind of the placeholder.
Yeah. Now I have mapped everything to the middle only. In our case, in our all of our implementations, we have mapped everything to middle only. We have never gone to any other cost elements of this. No, fine. Because that is more than sufficient for them. The client was not asking that a freight has to be separately shown. If he wants freight has to be separately shown, then what happens? You have to map it to a middle overhead, and then what happens? You have to take a report on middle overhead. Actually, it all depends upon how you want to do it. But what happens? As a middle overhead, it doesn't come, but any particular component can be even mapped to any other thing.
Right, I mean that's what like we did it for the client as well. I mean, we have mapped material overhead with the freight charges.
Why it is mapped to a material overhead? Okay, yeah.
Yes.
And click on create now. Fine, let's see if this works or not. Fine, that screen is not working for me. I don't know it's so. Yeah, it does not work. Fine, go there. Go for that. And then click on plus now. And then I will now go there. Click on plus. And then I will now put the item over here. Now find M10 underscore cost underscore test is item. Fine, go there. This is M10 underscore cost underscore test the one. So let me have the item now. Fine, go there. I will now go find the quantities. So the moment I put the quantity, what happens? The price defaults to 2. Then I'm going to override the price to $1. $1.00. Fine, no done. And then go there. Go to the schedules now. The schedules, what happens? Go there. And then let us now put the populate the date over here now. I go there. So I'll now say create some if I need it now. And then I'll now go and then ensure that it is a direct delivery. So that what happens that receive and deliver will be taking place in one go. So that what happens that you can perform the transactions quickly. Fine. The direct delivery is okay. Fine, go there. Click on OK and then submit. Fine. 2032 is not going to be submitted. Fine, click on submit. So let me submit it. And then what happens? It is submitted for approval. So 2032 is now submitted for approval. So this one was giving a problem. I'll now close it now. So 2032 is approved, fine. We go there, then make a result. Go there, then not make a result. So click on it and then go to the warehouse operations, then go to the results now. All of you, please, what happens, establish your friendship with Pradeep Yalagiri. He's now having a lot of knowledge on this, what happens, the costing area. So he'll be of a great help to you. Fine. Even though I have done a reasonable amount of work, but what happens only on a superficial side, but whenever there is a problem, what happens, I also used to participate with them and then I used to correct it.
Sir, nothing like that.
But because people who have worked on this now, what happens, they're really very good actually. Go there. I will now put the organization M101 and then give a tab and then click on OK. Which problem? Choosing the organization, fine. Go there. 2032, I'm going to make a reserve, fine. Click on the reserve expected shipments and then go for 2032. So 2032 and then give a tab. And then I will now click on search, it will be coming. And then I will now select it and then I will now perform a delivery in the inventory directly. 400 quantities. So by which what happens? Both the receive and deliver transactions are completed in one go now. Fine, go there. 100 quantities, I'm putting it now. Fine, go there. Destinations inventory and then I'll open the sub inventory over here now. Fine. So sub, fine, go there. And then click on create now. So I'm intentionally going to create a problem in create accounting because what happens? I have not given the what happens receiving inspection account as well as this. So 2032 is the one for which what happens? The GRN number is 1018. Fine. 2032 1018. You have to cheat now. Fine, go there. 2032 1018. Fine. 1018. Fine, the GRN number. Now what happens? I go there. Let me run the what happens? The concurrent for pushing it into costing. Fine, go there. So we are going to push it into costing. So here what happens? No financial transactions take place. Only when you do it, what happens? You go to the schedule process and then go to transfer transactions from receiving to costing. So this will now transfer what? The first one now. Fine. These two data will be pushed into costing now. Fine. This is called a receiving transaction. Fine, go there. So click on schedule new process. I will now perform transfer transactions. Transfer percentage. Transactions percentage. Receiving percentage. And then give a tab now. Transfer transaction and receiving to costing now. Fine, go there. So go fine. Transfer transactions from receiving to costing. So this is the one. Transfer transactions from receiving to costing is the one. Fine, go there. Click on OK. Now. We are going to receive it.
So there are separate programs for each of the type of the transactions.
Yes. Fine. I have told you yesterday, so I'll now again show you here. Now, fine. There are five different concurrents are there. Fine. Page up. I'll now show you. Fine. There are five different concurrents for pushing it now. Fine. So one is what? Transfer transactions from receiving to costing and then transfer transactions from inventory to costing. So these two are for the mainly for the purchase order thing as well as inventory ones. Inventory and purchase orders for this thing. Inventory, what happens? You'll be having a sub-inventory transfers, you'll be having intra-org transfers, and then you'll be having a move orders, and then what happens? The shipping to the customers, and then return to supplier, and then all those things. Fine, issuing material from what happens? This thing. And then even what happens, you are issuing what happens, you are what happens, WIP as well as what happens, the FG coming into inventory. So all these transactions will be under inventory. And then this is only purely for what happens, you are what's called the gate entry. Fine. The gate entry will be there for what happens when we are going via RMA. RMA will also be having a gate entry as well as what happens, your purchase order receipts will be having a gate entry. Right. So there is no internal requisition also. What happens there is no IRISO concept at all here. There is all considered as transfer orders. So every module will be what happens the supply chain management modules and then manufacturing and supply chain models will be using these two concurrents for pushing it. Right? So both the manufacturing and supply chain will be using these two concurrents for pushing it. Payables will use this concurrent for pushing it. And then what happens the receivables will be using what happens is it for manufacturing. From manufacturing product to costing will be coming over here. And then what happens the revenue lines. Import revenue lines run from receivables actually. It is not maybe a concurrent or I don't know what exactly it is now. Right? So these are the only five concurrents through which what happens the whole system data is now pushed into costing.
Okay. I think is there anything separate for the projects also?
Like, yes, projects is a separate one. And it is not mentioned over here at all. Fine. I don't know what exactly the projects the team was there. Actually, they have a separate one. Even on the purchase order itself, what happened? The project costing, project accounting, everything will be coming. They will be putting up the projects or attributes also on the requisition itself. But since I don't know what happens, I don't know. The project is again a big one. I'm trying to learn from it. I think this document is not explaining about project actually. Fine. I have not taken up. I've only taken up some glimpse of it. I've not taken anything from the project.
Okay.
So learn from projects also. Fine. Project costing, project billing, project accounting, everything is there. And then that also you have to learn it. Any doubts on this now? Fine. These five concurrents are responsible for pushing the source transaction type into this. Now, go there. Transfer transaction from receipt to costing. I click on OK now. And go there. So I'm not going to push it now. So the concurrent is going to run. It is not having any parameters. Fine. Click on submit. And then here what happens? I'm not going to perform the cost receipt accounting distributions now. So once when I perform the receipt accounting distribution, what happens? You can now see these two entries are getting made now. Right? the receiving instruction to AP accrual will be done now. Fine, bonus. You know, say this account will be created. Fine, go there. So it is not done. I'll now go and then open up one more tab region. Fine, go there. I will not here. What happens? I'll now go to the cost accounting directly. Fine, on it now. Now remember, for cost accounting, the employee must have the cost accountant role plus what happens? He must have the data access for users now. Fine. In this place, I told you about the data access for users now. the second set. The third set. Fine. Cost accountant for the cost store as well as cost accountant for the business unit is required. Fine. Two entries. Step number three is required. So that step you have to do it after all the 12 steps are completed now. Fine. After all the 12 steps, the third step has been done. Fine. The third step will be finally done after you give the role to the employee as well as what happens. You give data access for cost accountant to what happens, the cost store as well as cost accountant to business unit. Fine. Those two things will be done. Otherwise, what happens? It will fail actually. Fine. Go there. I will not go to the costing area. Fine. This icon is coming. Because we are given a role as well as what happens, I go to the receipt accounting. Afterwards, we'll now go to the cost accounting. Fine, click on the receipt accounting. We are not transfer transactions to receipt to costing. We'll now go to the receipt accounting and then let us now create the receipt accounting. Fine, click on it. So, I'll now click on it and then go to the receipt accounting. So, let me go and then create the distributions directly now. Fine, this distribution I'm going to create directly. Fine, let me create the receiving distributions now. Fine, go there. So, click on this task carousel. I'm in the receipt accounting. Create receipt accounting distribution I'm making now. Click on create account, receipt accounting distribution. I'm going to create a receipt accounting distribution. Here, what happens is now asking the BU name now. Fine. BU is a must now for this now. For the receipt accounting distribution, BU is a must. Fine. There is a parameter you have to pass on now. So the building unit, and then I'm going to click on submit now. So the concurrent will be running now. Fine. So 991 concurrent is running. Fine. Go there. Click on it. And then go to the monitor process area. And then here, what happens? 991 concurrent is running. Fine. Click on it now. So 991 is concurrent. So once when it is completed, what happens is we can now go and then see the receipt accounting distribution directly and go there. We can now review the receipt accounting distribution. We can go to the review receipt accounting distribution. So we have created the receipt accounting distribution. Now we are going to review it now. Fine, click on review receipt accounting distribution. Fine, you know what happens? I'll now put the item over here and then query now. Fine, this is M10. Fine. It is a cost. Fine, M10 underscore cost underscore test item. Fine, go there. Click on search now. And then you can use other parameters as well. Click on search. Once in the accounting distributions, what happens? You can now see the receipt accounting coming in. Yes, it's come now. Fine. So it has not come. So you can now go and see the 2032 and then 1018. Fine. So 2032 is the PO number. Fine. That's coming. And then afterwards, what happens? You can go there and see it's now into the inventory. And then all these information will be coming now. Fine. Supplier 1018. Everything is coming. The receipt date. Everything is coming. And go there, location, everything is coming. Fine. And then you go down, and then here at the bottom, what happens? You go there and see this one. Fine. The purchase order. The ledger unit cost is now one as far as the receiving is concerned. Fine. If you click on the distribution, you can now see the distribution here. So you can now see this what your receiving inspection to accrual will be hitting. This will be hitting on the debtor side, and then what happens? Accrual will be hitting on the creditor side. And go there and see now. But click on the distribution, what happens? You now see what happens. The accrual has gone to the credit side, and then the inspection has got to what happens? Go to the debit side. Fine, debit and credit. Accrual is on a debit. Fine, you can now see accrual or receiving inspection is on a debit, and then accrual is on a credit side. Fine, go there. Accrual is on the credit side, and then the receiving inspection on the debit side. Fine, clear on this. This is for the transactional currency, and then the ledger currency is also same now because what happens, we don't have any foreign currency involved now. Now, if I create account, if I do the create accounting, it will now fail because what happens, receiving inspection account is not set now. So journal entries will not be there. So let me do and then create the accounting. Fine, it will not fail now. And as long as that. So let us now perform the create accounting now. I click on it. So we will not do the create accounting for this. So we are now seeing everything now. Fine, go there. The debit and entry. Fine, go there. Go to the create accounting. Create accounting is going to fail now because what happens, the receiving inspection account is not split. Fine, go there. So the subledger accounting is what? Receipt accounting. Fine, go there and then choose the subledger accounting as receipt accounting. Fine, ledger is M10. And then give a tap. So the leave other thing fine. And then I will now accounting method is final. It's okay, fine. And then what happens? I will not make it the final. I will not make it the okay final. It's okay. Report is what I will not make it as a detail now. And then I will not transfer it to GL because GL is not set at all. So no transfer to GL. Fine. No there. Fine. Post to GL and GL. I'm not doing it now. Fine. Go there. So we can leave other parameters as such now. Fine. Go there and then give a thing. Fine. Click on submit now. This will now fail. Fine. Go there. So 992 is a concurrent which is not running. This will not do. And go there. So if you click on it and then what happens, you go to query, what happens, 990 account is not running. So it will now fail. So after completion, what happens, you can now see the failure over here. So create accounting is now being done now. Fine. Create accounting sub process is now running. So once when everything is completed, what happens, you can now see a failure in the receiving area itself, the costing receiving area itself. Fail now because receiving inspection account is. This may even go into warning, I think, probably. After completed, what happens? It may even go, yes, it's now going to warning. It's now gone to the warning now. You go there. And then here, what happens? The re-query on this now, fine, go there. We'll now go there. Go to the review, result accounting distributions. And then here, what happens? I'm going to make a re-query on the same thing. Fine, go there. Item is M10 underscore cost underscore test, the one. So click on search now. I'm going to make a search for it now. Go there. And then here, what happens? You can now see in the bottom. You go there. And then go to the journal entries now. So the journal entries will be having a failure. You don't show the failure. Fine, go there. There's an, what happens? A red mark is now coming. Fine. If you click on this red mark, what happens if you see? Fine. If you click on this, status change to red now. Fine, click on it. It will not show you this. Come on. It's not showing me. It will not show you that.
No, click on detach button.
Oh, detach button. Fine, click on detach button and see. Now, fine, go there. Let me have a look at it now. Fine, go there. I had to see this now. I used to see this error also. View errors is not showing you now. View errors. Result into inspection. Fine. Receiving inspection is the one. That is the error, I think, probably. The line itself is not showing entry. If you go on and see the entries now, you'll now see the entries now. The entries, first one, what happens, accrual has hit properly, but receiving inspection has not hit properly at all. Got it now? Fine. That is having a red color. So if you see the entries, what happens, you'll now see the entry is now saying what happens, the receiving inspection is having error now. Because accrual is set, but receiving inspection is not hit. Clear on this now? Fine. So we are not set this now. Fine, go there. So since we are not set the receiving inspection account, accrual is set, that entry is properly hit. But here, what happens? There is no account at all. Fine, it's not set. The error is coming. Okay, fine, close it now. Now we will not push this into what happens. Transfer transaction will be invented to costing. I'll not do it now. Fine, we will not do it together now. Fine. Both the accounts will not do it together. Both the receiving inspection account as well as the inventory valuation account will not do it together now. Fine, go there. Click on the schedule new process, and then here what happens? Do it together. Fine, go there. Transfer transactions from inventory to costing. What is fine? Click on OK now. When you transfer transactions from receiving to costing, there is no parameter, but for transfer transaction from inventory to costing, what happens? The cost org is asked for. Fine, go there. You're not asking for the cost org. Fine, click on it. So put your cost org over here and then click on submit now. So we are now submitting again. Fine, click on OK. No doubt. So refresh it. And then you can see it's not running. Now, in the meantime, what happens? We have to go there. We will have to go to cost accounting. Fine. For cost accounting, what happens? We have the periods now. We have to open the periods now. So then only what happens? You can do it now. First activity is what? After you go to the cost accounting, we have to create the periods now. Fine. Go there. Open the periods. Fine. Click on it. And then you're going to open the periods. So here, you can now see what happens. You have to open the periods. Manage cost accounting periods. The first activity I have to do now. Fine. Click on manage cost accounting. Receipt accounting is not having any periods, whereas cost accounting is having a period. So let me put my cost org and then query it now. Fine. M10 and then give a tab. I'm going to query it now. Thank you on search now. I'm not going to query the period. Find M10. Drop it down. It doesn't come with the normal values at all. Search now.
I think it was M10001.
No, cost org. Okay, cost org is only, that is the code is only M10001.
Correct.
Cost org name is only this now. I click on search now. So if you search for it, what happens? You'll not find anything at all. Go there. I'm searching for it. What happens? You will not find any, what happens, the period there. Fine. Okay, not no saying MZN cost arc. What happens? Everything is showing as yellow color. Never open, never open, never open. Fine, go there. Let us open the period now. Fine, go to the actions and then open the target period. Fine, and now open the period. That's what January is the first period. Fine, okay, now I'm going to open it up. So you're opening it up now. Fine, go there. Here also, we don't have a refresh button here. Financials, they give, I think, whereas for the costing, they're not giving it. So a refresh button is a good one. Nah? So I had again go and then search for it. I don't know why they are not giving it. You know, such what happens, it has to open the current period now. So what happens, January has to open now, fine. Current period is March, prior period, February, nothing is open now, fine. You know, go there, open the next period also. Go to the what's called open target period, it doesn't open the March also. Fine, go there, drop it down. And open up to something also, fine, up to June, July also, open up. Fine, go there. Click on open up to July, click on okay. This can be opened only when the financial periods are open now, fine. The period cannot be opened. This period cannot be opened because this period is never opened in the open status at all. Fine, what else? So we will not see whether we have opened the financial period or not. We opened it, nah? Yeah, for the payables, at least we already opened it. Actually. We already opened it up. Fine. Now, one more thing is what? We cannot open all the periods. Yes, I have forgotten that now. Fine. If you see this, what happens? One by one only we can open now. Fine. Just like in inventory, we can open only one. Here, what happens? You select and then click on view period details. We can open one by one now. Fine. January is open. I cannot open directly March or April. Fine. Just like in inventory also, what happens in EBIS, what happens one by one. Here also what happens, we have to open only one by one now. Remember, I forgot on that. So select it February, select it, and then what happens, open target period. one by one only we can open. If I click on okay, so we can open only, you cannot open directly the period. So it is not done. Where is the re-query button here? Search by year. Say 2018 and then I give a go now. February is open. Now we go there and then open the March. One by one only you can open. I forgot to tell you. Open target period. And we made a blunder by making 35 cost talk for one of the client. What happens every month he has to sit and then open all the 35 periods now. Afterwards, what happens? We want to club everything. Oracle did not do it because we have a lot of transactions on this. And then so what happens? Now it is not advisable. Every month you sit and then open all the periods now. So club all the relevant inventory all into one cost arc. So if you go there and then re-query it, now fine. You can now see the March will be open now for this. Now fine. Everything is blue. I don't want blue, you say. Then what happens? It'll go away now. Up to February and March is open now. Fine. Yes. Open. Fine. Go there. So the period opening is not done. Now what happens? We go and then we have to create a run control now. Fine. The next activity is what? You go there. This contract would have completed now. Fine. Transfer transactions to inventory costing is now completed. Fine. Go there. Now you go there. We have to create a run control. Click on it and then we'll now directly go to create cost accounting distributions. Like receipt accounting distributions, what happens? We are now creating a cost accounting distribution. Create cost accounting distributions. I'm going to make it now. Go there. Here, what happens? We will now create a run control for this. And click on plus now. We are going to create a run control. Click on pun. I will now make a run control for this now. Fine. The run control is M10 underscore run control. Get created. And then you had to enable all the processes basically, the pre-processor, cost processor, COGS recognition, cost distribution, everything has to be enabled. And then give a save. Afterwards, what happens after having given, what happens? You go to the details of this one. Fine. Select it and go to the details of it. No? In the details, what happens? You go to the action. Fine. Click on the, in the actions. What happens? Add a row. You are going to add a row. And then drop down your cost arc will be coming because we have got, we are given only data access for users only for one cost arc. Remember, we are given only for one cost arc will be coming. In reality, what happens? We are given 35 cost arcs for one user. Wow, so much of a problem. Wow, it's a very, very tedious one because of a mistake. What happens? We are given the data access for users for 35 cost arcs because what happens? He is the only guy who has to do it now. So we are given. So everywhere, what happens? You have to get the run control and then what happens? You have to do each and everything. Go there. Click on save. So click on save. So we have not done this. Afterwards, what happens? We will not schedule the concurrent. So a run control with the details we had to give for every cost arc. For the user, whatever you want now. Fine. Yeah, the pair has to be done now. And then remember, all the things are enabled. Fine. Click on the schedule process. Now it is now going to create the distribution. Fine. This is not having any parameters, remember. Fine. Click on submit now. Whereas when you create the distribution for the receipt accounting, it was asking the parameter of a business unit. But here it is not asking anything at all. Fine. Click on OK. Please note down whatever I say. Now, fine. So much of the things I'm saying because of we have worked on a lot of things on this now. Fine. But what happens? You note down everything. When you go to the field, you should not be annoyed on seeing something as such. So create cost accounting distributions are running. Fine, go there. They're not running. Now distributions will be created, but accounting will fail again. Fine. Accounting will fail. Distributions will be coming. Fine. The IPV will be debited. Fine. And that what happens? The receiving inspection gets knocked off. But when you do the create accounting, what happens? We don't have both accounts there. Fine. Both accounts are not there. So create accounting is going to fail. Fine, go there. Not done. It takes a longer time. This concurrent takes a longer time. Fine. Create what happens? Your cost distribution, costing distribution. Fine. Receiving distribution is okay fast, but what happens? Costing distribution takes a pretty long time actually. Fine. We have to wait for some time. And then in the meantime, what happens? You can go there and then query it. No, fine. Go there. We don't done it. And close it now. Fine. Save and close. We had to come out of a save and close. There is a bug here. I'll tell you what exactly the bug. Now, fine. Of course, we go there. And then here, what happens? Go there. Review the cost accounting distribution. Review the cost accounting distribution. Click on it now. This is the one which I'm going to review it now. I go there and then let me query the item now. Item is CM10 underscore cost underscore test. I'll go there and then click on search now. I'm going to search for it now. It does not come. Fine. Go there. So the cost accounting is not done. Fine. Purchase order receipt. Fine. All these things are coming. 500. Everything is now coming. Fine. And read all these things. Fine. Go down. The bottom, what happens? You'll be having what happens? The costing coming up. So the costing is yet to come. The concurrent is not fully completed. What happens? The cost information is yet to come now. So again, re-query now. The concurrent is still running. So what happens? You had again re-query now. Fine. What happens? Yet to come now. Fine. It's not half only come. Fine. Click on search again. When you search it, what happens? You go there. Now it has come. Fine. The PO number is now coming. All these things are. Click on the cost distribution. You can now see the corresponding entries getting made now. Go there and have a look at it now. Fine. Go there. So is again still not come now. Fine, go there. So the entries are net to come now. Fine. So it is in the process, I think. So again, make a research now. Click on it. Click on search now. Is this doing step by step? It's a very heavy concurrent actually. Fine, go there and then do it now. Now what happens? You can now see on the cost distribution value is coming. The inventory valuation is debited, and then what happens? Receiving inspection is now created. So your inventory valuation is what? Inventory valuation is debited, and then the receiving inspection get credited as a knocked off. Now let us go on and do the what happens? Create accounting. Now both the accounts are missing, and so what happens is going to fail. Create accounting is going to fail. If you go on and see the journal entries, what happens? There won't be any entries because they're not in the grid accounting. But in fact, what happens? The item is costed now. Fine. We go on and have a look at the costing now. Fine. It's now fully costed. So costing status is what is now fully, but not accounted. It is not accounted. So accounting is not done. Fine. Go there. Costing is now fully done. So we can even review the item cost directly. Fine. Click on it and then go there and then have a look at the cost now. Fine. Go there. Click on it and then now go on the review item cost. So if you put the item cost, it'll be coming automatically. Fine. Here only we have the review item cost now. Fine. Go there. There's cost underscore test. Cost is, and then click on search now.
This is an average costing, right?
It's an average costing. Yeah. So what happened? The total unit cost is one. The total unit cost is one. Because what happened? The cost profile we are given only for the average costing. So average costing or standard costing, you will now design only on the costing profile and not on the inventory level. Inventory level, you don't design anything at all. Inventory, we don't set up anything at all. Only on the costing side, what happens? You design it as an average costing or a standard costing. And go there. We have even done one complex thing of what using the average costing, we did the standard costing, right? In one of the projects. Okay, fine. That way also we can do it also, fine. It was only suggested by the client, actually, fine. You do like this. So we use the average costing and then we did finally only a standard costing. That can also be done, fine. So all very, very, very fluctuations. It's a very big subject. It's not an easy subject at all. Fine, go there. Now what happens? We'll now run the create accounting. Fine, go there. The total unit cost is coming as $1. Click on it. And then here, what happens? You go there and create accounting. Click on create accounting in the bottom. Accounting, I'm going to make it now. This will now fail because what happens? Not done. And go there. Here, it is cost management. And go there. It's a cost management. You go to the cost management. The ledger is M10. And then leave around. Fine. Go there. Accounting is fine. Okay, fine. Is in a detail now. And then this, you don't transfer it to GL at all because GL is not set now. Fine. Go there. Leave alone the remaining ones. If you know, or you can even fine tune all these things, process category and all, fine. There are so many things are there. If you know full amount of financials, you can even understand it. Now, click on submit now. Since I have only a very elemental knowledge, whatever I'm doing, whatever I know. 999 is a concurrent which is running now. Fine. Go there and have a look at it now. This will again end up in a warning. Okay. In the meantime, what happens? I'll now make one more purchase order. Fine. Go there. I will now. 2032, I'll not make it, and then what happens? I'll not pick one more purchase order. Fine, go to what happens. The manage orders 2032. So I will not create one more purchase order. This time, but a value of 2 now. Fine, go there. Go there. 2032. Then give a tap and then click on search now. So we are going to copy this purchase order. Fine, go there. We are not going to make a duplicate order. A repeat order, I'm going to make it. I'm select it and then go to actions and then go to duplicate now. So we are not making a repeat order for this now. Click on repeat. We are not making a repeat order now. So here, what happens? They've gone there, and then this place, what happens? What I'm doing is I go there and then make a change to price of what happens? 100 at 1, 100 at 2 means what? How much? So I'll now make it as 2. So the cost will be how much now? Initially, 100 at 1, 100 to 100 valuation, inventory value is 800. Now what happens? 100 at 2, it'll be 200. So $300 and 200 items, it'll be 1.5. The average cost will be adjusted to 1.5. So I made a small change on this now. Fine, go there and click directly submit. So 2033, I'm submitting it properly.
Now, one more thing, I mean, not related to this. For this, like, do we have like the transaction managers actually for the inventory transaction?
We are given the run control. Now, in the run control, we have the cost processes there. There are four cost processes there. One is a pre-processor, one is a normal processor, one is a cost cogs recognition, and then there is one more processor. So, those are the only processes which are there. There is no separate, what happens, a costing manager or anything with it. Okay. The run control only we have those processes basically.
Okay. Apart from that, what I was trying to ask is like, you know, we have the transaction managers in the EBS, right? Like, you know, for example, to move the WIP transactions, okay, from one operation to there's a like a WIP move transactions, transaction managers in.
We have a resource worker, we have a material worker, all these things will be running there. I have not learned the manufacturing actually. So once when you learn manufacturing, you can understand about what else concurrent will run now. Fine. I don't know about it.
No, even the inventory transactions also, right? Like,
you know, we also need to learn now. Fine. I'm now learning only. I mean, the learning process. So one during the inventory, I will not tell you about all this. I will learn it now. I don't have mood at all, basically, to sit up and learn it. So once when I learn it, when I conduct the inventory training, I'll be telling, I will not show you the inventory costing also. So inventory transactions also will be having costing. So since I have practiced only purchasing, what happens? I know only purchasing. I'm yet to practice other things basically.
Okay.
Maybe during inventory, I will not show you this. Fine, go there. Now what happens is the create accounting has again hit, what happens, a warning symbol now, fine, go there. So it's now gone to the warning and go there and then have a look at it now, fine. So here, what happens, you go there and then have a look at it. Click on it now. And then you go to the review accounting distribution now, fine. Click on review cost accounting distributions now. Review cost accounting distributions, I'm clicking on it and I'm going to do it now, fine, go there. So here, I will now put the item over here now, fine, it's the M10 underscore cost underscore test now, fine, go there, give a tap and then click on search now. I'm going to search for it now, fine, go there. And then here, what happens, you go down and see this place, fine, go to the journal entries now. The journal entries, if you go there, see now, fine, let us know what happens. Both the lines are now having error now. Because what happens, your inventory valuation is also missing, as well as the receiving inspection is also missing. Even though the amounts are posted, the debit and credit are posted, what happens, both the accounts are missing, and so what happens, not showing a red color mark. Clear on this now. Now we are going to give the accounting now. Fine. The receiving inspection account, as well as what happens, the inventory valuation account is going to be given. Fine. Apart from that, everything has come now. Fine, go there. So now what happens, we go there and then see the average costing now. Fine, click on done now. Fine, go there. Now, what happens? There's no fully costed. Okay, fine. No, that was the previous entry. No, fine. We have not done it actually. So I had to transfer transaction from inventory costing. Fine. There's only one entry. So the second entry has to be made now. Fine. Go there. So let us now run the what happens. Transfer transaction from inventory costing. You can even repeat the concurrent now. Fine. Transfer transaction from inventory costing is one. Fine. Go there. Because the parameters are the same. What happens? I selected and resubmit the concurrent now. Fine. Repeat concurrent. I'm going to do it. I click on resubmit. Oh no, we are not received it. No, fine. We have to receive it. Go there and receive it now. First of all. So we have to receive it now. So purchase order 2033 is now made. Fine. Have we made the purchase order first of all? Submitted, now? Yeah. Purchase. Yeah. Purchase order submitted. And go there. So let me go on and receive it now. First, go there. Let me receive it now. So the previous entry is not showing. Right? And then now what happens? You go there. You go to the warehouse operations and then perform the reserves for this 2033. And go there. Go to the reserves now. 2033. I'm going to receive it now. So click on it, and then here what happens, you go there, go to the receive expected shipments, and then 2033. 2033, and then give a tap, and then click on search now. You select it, and then click on receive now. You're receiving it now. Fine, select it, and then put 100 quantities over here now. Fine, now the price is 2, fine, remember, fine, go there, and then I'm going to receive it now. Go there, submit entry now. Then click on create receipt now. And click on create receipt. Then click on submit now. So 1019-2033 is a combination of fine, go there is not done. Now what happens, you go there, you will now perform the receipt accounting first of all. Fine. The cost accounting for the previous one has ended in error. Fine, both the things are end in error. Now what happens, we'll now perform the receipt accounting for the second one. Fine, go to the receipt accounting. And then we'll now perform the receipt accounting. Fine, go there. So before doing the receipt accounting, what happens, we have pushed it. Oh God, I have to set it up and then do it here. Okay, let me set it up now. Fine. I have to set up the accounts and then do it now. I forgot on the lecture. Fine, go there. Let us now set up the accounts. I'll not go there. I will not go to the, I'll not set up the inventory valuation as well as the what happens, the receiving inspection account. I'm going to set up and go there. Set up a maintenance. I have not set up actually. I pushed it. I don't know what will happen now. Fine. I only pushed it and then I have not created the distribution basically. Fine, go there. I think that will work. I think. Click on the implementation manager. Here, what happens? The M10 project. I go there. And again, many people are told that this is not the way, sir. That is the way. Okay, anyway, whichever way you feel like, what happens, you go there, you achieve the final results. Now, I manage mapping set through the functional setup manager. We can go this thing, that thing, and all this. Anyway, whichever you know, fine. Whichever way you feel like, you first land up on the particular task. Fine. Go there, go to the manufacturing, are there? Fine. Through the cost accounting, we had to go to the through the defined cost accounting. We had to go to the manage mapping sets. Go there. And then again, go for this form and go to the manage mapping sets. I will now choose to what happens in this area. I will now choose what cost management and then click on apply and go to task now. Apply and go to task. And then here, what happens? I will now see the receiving inspection as well as the inventory valuation account. I'm going to create. Click on it. Receiving inspection. I will now create. Receiving inspection. Receiving inspection account. Fine. Go there. I will now get the value for us now. So go down and then click on plus now. Let me add it now. So drop it on, and then I'll choose my this thing, M10. And then give a save on the top. Receiving inspection account. I will not just give an expense account. Fine. I don't have any account at all. Fine. Maybe 3 or 4 accounts are there. I go there. But in reality, what happens is they will be having a separate account for each and everything. Financials will be giving an account. Fine. Go there. I will now say the two instance got 10-100-. What happens? 1002 is the one. I will now make it as a default. This can be done for very many variants basically. For inventory or sub inventory, and then category and then item number. Fine. There are 4 such variants are there for this one. For every variant, we can have a separate account actually. Right. The receiving inspection account can be a variant for an inventory or for a sub inventory, for a category, as well as item number also. But I have set it as a default now. Fine. In reality, what happens? This will be set by the financials team, how they want to have the receiving inspection to be hit. Right. If they want to have item level hitting also, what happens? That many entries they have to make now. I don't know how they do it now. Fine. That's why they say it's a very laborious job for them. Fine. This has been pushed into what happens? Supply chain team. Supply chain team is now doing everything now. Because they say that they don't have time to do all these accounting, man. Hundreds of accounts they have to set now. And then the maintenance also, when any mistake is coming, you have to maintain it. So now the supply chain team in our company is not doing it. There are 4 variants to it, fine. Remember, fine. Click on it and then here, whatever they'll go over the inventory valuation now. Fine. Next is what I will now say inventory valuation. Here itself, you can see plenty of accounts will be there actually. So there's a low rate of various gains, all the so much learning financials I don't like at all because of what happens. It takes a long time to understand each and everything. Fine, go to the inventory valuation. Supply chain is easier. Fine. And go there. And then click on plus. My management always wanted me to learn financials, but no, I always refused. No, no, sir, it's really a very horrible job, basically. No, if you learn it, it'll be excellent. That's what my manager always used to say. Don't give me the responsibility. I will not help them, but what happens, I will not learn it fully. I used to help them actually, whenever they are struck. Because of what happens, a good exposure is there. What happens, some problems I used to identify and then tell them, but I will not learn it fully. The one, I click on plus now. Here also, whatever, they'll be having all the 4 variants actually. And both the receiving inspection account as well as having all the 4 variants, I go there. So here, inventory valuation, I will not give an asset account. So I don't have any account at all. I go there and then set it as a default. So both the receiving inspection account as well as the inventory valuation account has got 4 variants, ARC, sub-inventory, category, item number specific. Like you are also giving. And now I give a common one for everything. Now I go there, click on 7 plus. In reality also, what happens, you give one common account afterwards for every variant, you make an entry over there. Click on plus plus and then for each and every variant, whatever way they want, what happens, you make entry. Because if any of them fails, at least whatever default will fire actually. Fine. If any of them is missing, the default will fire. And then what happens, it will be accounting. Click on 7 close. Now, having done this, what happens, you go there. Fine. Having done this, let us now go to the receipt accounting distribution. Fine. Click on it now. Fine. Let us now create the receipt accounting distribution. Fine. Go there. We'll now create the receipt accounting distribution. Also. Fine. We have already pushed it into the receiving now. Fine. I think we are done it. Fine. Go there. Transfer transactions from receiving to costing has been done. Have we done it? Okay, let me do it now. Fine, I have not done it, I think, probably. So, I don't know. I'm sure. Transfer transactions from receiving to costing, I'll do it now. I go there. Transfer transactions from receiving to costing, I'll do it. Click on it. So, let me resubmit the concurrent now. I click on resubmit it now. So, it's now asking you what happens, resubmit the concurrent, and then with the volume. Okay, fine. There is no parameter at all for this now, fine. So we can very well pause it on and go. So it's not running. Transfer transaction from receiving to costing is now running. Now what happens? We go there and then do the receipt accounting distributions. Now. It's not done. Fine, go there. We'll go and then have a look at it. Fine, click on done. We go to this thing, receipt accounting. Create receipt accounting distributions for the second entry. And go there. And then the business unit is now asking for now. Here it is asking for the business unit. Whereas in the cost accounting, when you are performing the cost accounting distributions, no parameters being asked for. But when you want to transfer transactions from inventory to costing, it is asking for the cost target. So go there, click on submit. Yeah.
Not yet.
So click on submit now. Submit again now. Right? 005 is now running. And go there. So click on it now. Go there and say this now. So once when it is completed, you know, see the receipt accounting distributions over there. Fine, go there. Review the receipt accounting distribution now. Fine, review the receipt accounting distribution. Review the receipt accounting distribution. And then for the item now, inventory item. Fine, go there. EM10 underscore cost underscore test. Fine, go there. And then click on search now. The second entry is also coming. Fine, go there. So this is the second entry. Fine, I will now see which is the top one or the bottom one. Fine, go there. So 2033, the top one of the top one, fine, go there and then have a look at it. No, fine, go there. And then here, the costing information, and I get to re-query it again. I think it's not come. Fine, it's not come. Fine, it's not $2. The distributions also, what happens, it will come now, fine, go there, it's not coming. Fine, dividend credit. And then what happens, there is each and everything will be having entry. The item cost will not be varying as well. Now, let us go and then what happens, you do the create accounting. If this will not pass. Click on create accounting. Now it will pass. Click on it. So we go there because we already have specified those statements and go there. I will now go to the receipt accounting distribution. Receipt accounting ledger is M10 and then give it tap. And then what happens the final? And then I will now make it the detail down. Fine, go there. And then I will not post it to GL at all. Fine, go there. Fine, go there.
New chick on the key. Talk to the mama chapta. Talk to the mama chapta.
You can't do it. Back be fine. 88006, now fine, go there. So it's now submitted. Click on it and then 0006 is running. Now this time what happens, you must be able to see the accounting very perfectly. There was a warning previously. Now what happens, create accounting will not have any warning at all. And it will be getting succeeded perfectly. Fine, completed. The report is not coming. Oh God, it is again entering warning now. Maybe, but I think it will now do the thing clearly. Fine, go there. It will be doing the things clearly. Fine, go there. Click on it and then what happens? Now again, review the receipt accounting distribution. Receipt accounting distribution, I'm going to review it now. Fine, go there. And then I'm going to put the item over here now. Fine, M10 underscore cost underscore test. Then give it a tab. And then click on search now. Yeah, we're on the top entry. Oh God. It is not yet done. I made something as a ulta pulta. Fine, have a look at it because when I was speaking, I have forgotten the flow actually. Fine, go there. I will now detach it and then see this now. Fine, errors. Expand it now. Expand this now. It shows what happens. Receiving inspection account is still not there. That's what it is saying. Maybe I think I may have to even what happens restart the system as such now. Fine. I think we have to restart the system now. Rather, restart the thing. That may be the reason. Fine, let me do that now before I do the cost accounting there. Now, fine, so it's no giving. Fine, let me log out and log in now. Sometimes log out and log in is required. Fine, click on it. Log out and log in now. So sign out and sign in now. Click on confirm. Sometimes sign out and sign in is required. And before I do the cost accounting area, I will not see this. Fine, go there. No sign out. So let me go and then log in now. Fine, go there for the what's called will now for the cost accounting distributions. Will not do it. Fine, go there. It's the M10. And then underscore EMP1, go there and then click on sign in now. Go there and then here, what happens? You go there, click on the schedule process. Let me transfer transactions from inventory to costing now and go there. Click on more and then let me do this now and go there. I'll go to the schedule process now. Whenever any major activities there, what happens? You sign on, sign out and sign in is the best thing now. And go there. So transfer transactions from inventory to costing. Transfer transactions, receiving to costing is not done. Fine, go there. When you transfer transaction from inventory to costing, it has got a parameter, remember? It has got a parameter. Transfer transaction from inventory to costing, fine, click on resubmit it. When you're resubmitting it, it will now ask for the parameter that you want to pass the same argument or not. Yes, the argument is the same, M10 cost arg only. So I can very well repeat the concurrent now. Fine, click on it, resubmitting it again. If it's a different one, it should not resubmit, remember? So since it's the same one, what happens? I'm doing it now, fine, go there. And now, what happens? You'll now go to the costing area, fine, go there. And then here again, one small bug is there because of which what happens? It will not work very properly. There is a bug fixing routine has been given by the Oracle. And then that will be set right in release 13. Fine, go to the cost accounting. So before you create the distribution, what you have to do is you have to do one simple one three-step exercise you have to do now, fine, go there. You click on it and then here what happens? You go there. And then here you go to the what's called a create cost accounting distribution. This is step number one now. Here you go there. You query for your cost or run control. You query your run control. Click on it. Make a search for it now. here. This is a bug actually. Probably they have never fixed it. I'm not very sure about it, but I know I'm doing the bug fix ability. And select it and then here what happens. The run control details you have to delete now. Fine, click on delete now. The run control detail has to be deleted. You have to save and close now. This is step number one. It is a three-step process, remember. Save and close. And then again go there. Second step now. Fine, click on it. And the second step, what happens? You will do it now. Fine. And the second step, again go there. The same place you go there. And go there. And then again, what happens? They create cost accounting distributions. And then query your run control now. Fine. M10 is a control. We go there and then query it. Fine. Click on search now. And you can see all the four processes are coming here actually. So you see the pre-processor, cost processor, cost recognition, cost distribution. And all the processes are done now. Fine. Here, what happens? You introduce the run control. First step is what? Delete it and then save and close. Next, what happens? You introduce it now. Fine. Go there and then drop it down and then put the cost arrow over here now. And then the cost book also you put over here now. Now it's save and close. There's step number two now. Fine. Half time, so you can save and close now. The third step only you will run the process. Click on yes now. You're not saving the changes. Thank you for this. Now what happens? You go there and then run it on the third step. So this has to be done every time. First time, what happens? Okay, for next time onwards, what happens for each and every time run? We have to do this thing. This is a bug actually. And then they are saying they're working on it. And then I don't know whether they have corrected in this instance or because this is already been handed over back to Oracle now. So I don't know whether they have done it or not. Now what happens? You shift the process. Before which what happens? See whether the previous concurrent is not completed or not. Transfer transaction of inventory costing is not completed or not. See, it's not succeeded. Now what happens? You go and then schedule this process. So click on it and then there's no parameter for it. I'm going to click on submit now. Now what happens? Then only what happens? You'll not be able to see the costing distributions coming up now. Otherwise you won't be able to see it now. Fine. This concurrent will not take a pretty long time, 1 or 2 minutes now basically. Credit cost accounting distributions is not running.
Is the decogs concept is also there?
Default cogs, yeah. One cogs is there, but I don't know whether the default cogs is there or not. I'm not sure about it. The cogs account is there in order management actually. You have to learn in order management about the default cogs and other things. And how you're going to do it. Cost of goods sold has to come over there because what happens is sales minus cost will be the gross margin actually. So for the calculation of it, I think probably they'll be having those things. It will all be shifted from the organization parameter to the respective financial modules, you know, basically. So some accounting we have to see there, whether, what exactly they're doing it actually. So financial guys will be doing a lot of activity on this. Now, fine, go there, click on save and close and then come out of it and then you know, review the distribution. Fine, go there, click on it. Review the cost accounting distribution. Now, fine, you go there and then click on the review cost accounting distributions, go there. And then item is what? You put the item over here now. Item is EM10. _cost_test. So mark and go there. And then click on search now. Two entries have to come. Both entries have come now. And go there. Now this is also fully costed now. And go there. So it's fully costed. So what happens? All the entries will be coming. Cost distributions, everything is coming now. Fine, all the things are there. And then what happens? You go to the cost information. What happens? It will not show you the average cost now. So this transactions cost is not showing you. So transaction wise is not showing you the cost now. So if you go to the item cost, it will be showing you the average cost now. It's not showing the unit cost. The cost distributions are coming by each and every line. Fine. Everything is not coming. Journal entries you are ready to make now. Fine. Go there. And then we'll now go and then click on done. And then we'll now see the item review cost. It will be 1.5. Click on review item cost. It will be 1.5. Because what happens is the average costing. Fine. M10 _ what happens? Cost. _test. Fine, give a tab. So click on search now. You will now find the cost as 1.5. It's 1.5. Clear on this now, fine. Previously, 100 items are received at $1, and then now 100 items are received at $2. The total value of the inventory is what? 100 plus 200 is 300. So 300 by 200 is 1.5. Now let us run the create accounting. This time it has to succeed now because I have only restarted the instance naturally. So let us now create accounting and go there. Let us now do the create. Click on create accounting. Hopefully it has to come properly. Fine, go there. Go to the cost management now. The last part of this exercise actually. EM10 and then give a tab. And then everything is okay. Let me get the detail. And here let me get no. This is no now. Fine. So click on submit now. 011 is now running. Fine, go there. Wait for the cost process to run now. This time I should not be a warning. There I saw a warning actually. This it has to run in a proper manner actually. create accounting is running. Fine, 11881101. They make it big now. 88011 is not running. Create accounting sub process. It's completed. 111 has to, I don't want warning at all in 111. 011. Oh God, again it is not. 011 has gone into a warning now. Fine. But I have seen it normally works very well. Right? Maybe what happens, I have done this before transferring it. What happens, I should have done it now. But I did it after transferring. I don't know whether there is a problem or not. Fine, go there. You know, again, go on the review the distribution. Fine, go there. Click on the create. Review the, what happens, cost accounting distribution. Cost accounting distribution. Sometimes there it will not show a warning, but it will not go review cost accounting distribution. Sometimes there it will not show a warning, but here what happens? The journal entries would have been made. Go there, cost underscore test, and then go tab. And then review the cost accounting distribution for this now. No, go on and see it now. Fine, go there. And the second one, you go to the journal entries now. Fine, go there. Go down and then see it's now. Fine, see, there is no error at all. There is no error at all. Fine, there is no error at all. You're not touch it and see it now. Touch it on the says there's no error at all. Even though there it's showing a warning, what happened? There is no red color at all. And then there is no view errors is also not coming. Actually. If the error is there, only what happens will be view error. So it's perfect now. Fine. I don't know if you have to go and then see the warning message, what exactly the warning message and all, there will be some other warning which may be there actually. We are unable to understand those things. Fine. But remember, the mistake I did is what? I had not restarted the system actually. So once when you restarted it, afterwards what happens, you start to push, it will definitely happen properly. This completes the costing transactions now. And transactional errors also will not show you a lot of things. The receiving, you can go and see whatever error is there, all these things will not show you. Distributions, everything is not made. So as far as costing is concerned, what happens, we have two types of costing, fine. These two, receiving transactions as well as what happens, this is not done. In the financial accounting is not done. Now, what happens is now eligible for pushing it to GL via SLA. So financial accounting is different from purchasing accounting. Now, purchasing accounting, where you are now seeing only the charge account in very many ways, there will be plenty of charge accounts. That is only for what happens, expense monitoring actually, spend monitoring. How much you are spending against which account you are monitoring it. And then here, what happens, it is a different one. Here, it is a financial accounting. Everything will be hitting only the inventory valuation account. And then inventory valuation account is the ultimate one, which whatever the financial accounting will take place. There is a difference between cost accounting and financial accounting. So cost accounting, what happens, you know, see the product cost, we can even see, fine, by which what happens, the COGS account will be hit. And then what happens, we can now calculate the gross margin for each and every product. Whereas financial accounting will now say the overall, what happens, the company's profit and loss. Good. I hope that it is a very tough one. Fine. How many of you are understood it? Can you tell me you understood it correctly? It's not an easy one actually. And then what happens? Pradeep Yalagiri has got a very good conceptualization basically. Fine. Announce yourself as a friend of him in your group actually. And then if you have any doubts, he will be able to clarify your doubts. Also. Even the other modules costing, I don't know. Fine. Only purchasing costing, we have done it actually. In the field also, what happens? I was involved only in the purchasing costing. Nothing else I was involved. Oh God, nobody is opening their mouth. Fine. Somebody please speak. Anybody has understood it? Pradeep, have you understood it at least?
Yeah, conceptually, like I think I got it.
Okay, very good.
I mean, I need to, since you are doing it so too fast, but I'm able to understand what you are.
Yeah. The thing is what you have to enter the, what happens, your inventory valuation account as well as your receiving account. And then afterwards restart the system. And then afterwards you push it into the respective areas. Right? Transfer transactions from receiving to costing. And then you create the accounting. And then again, transfer transactions from inventory costing. And then do the credit accounting. You will not succeed actually. So I made a mistake of one of them. So again, next time what happens, it ran up a day error. So after I restarted it, what happens, it started working properly. What happens is the cost accounting part.
Yeah, and also I think like, you know, compared to EBS, the number of steps what we need to do is more, I think. Probably, right. I think like from the implementation perspective, we need to think like, you know, scheduling the things.
Was very virtually telling, my sir, too much of a steps are actually. Yeah. Too much of a steps basically when compared.
No, I think it will be scheduled, right? I mean, it will be scheduled to run.
Of course.
people has to understand, like, you know, what
you have a bug, what happens when something is not properly transferred, then what happens, you'll have it. Fine, you have to go and then analyze each and everything. Which transaction is not done properly in the inventory side, all these things. Fine.
Yeah, yeah.
Bug analysis, and then what happens, doing this thing is really very, very, very difficult. Actually, it's a laborious job. I don't say it's a very difficult job, it's a laborious job in the field, actually. So all of you, please take notes now. Fine. First of all, fully take notes for the setups as well as transactions. And then afterwards, when you start to do this now. Fine. It's not an easy one. It's a very difficult one. And then what happens? You have to do it very perfectly. And if anybody has succeeded in doing the setups and transactions, please put a mail to me. I will definitely appreciate that. What happens? I would love to see my students succeed in each and everything. Fine. That's my ultimate aim.
One question. After you receiving, before you, you know, creating the distribution account, you run that pushing transfer of inventory to
transfer costing. From receiving to costing, then afterwards I create the distribution. Similarly, transfer transaction from inventory to costing, and then I create the distribution.
So, when we need receiving to costing and when we need the inventory to costing, is that?
See, they are all concurrent, scheduled concurrent. They'll be running periodically. As the transaction, you wait for 10 minutes, everything would have been transferred into costing area.
So that means after receiving, these two at least need to be run, right, in the background?
Yes, naturally. When you, I'm just saying on a single costing case basis. In reality, what happens, you'll be running it on a SRS basis or on a need-by basis, you'll be running it. Fine, let us say what day you would like to cost.
So I'm trying to understand that the hierarchy. So first the receiving to costing. First
receiving to costing, then afterwards the inventory to costing, of course.
Okay, got it.
Any other doubts? I know that you'll be having plenty of doubts. You won't succeed at all in the first time, fine? Because what happens if you make some small mistake in the setup, what happens? You'll not be able to see the costing at all. Distribution will not be coming at all. Whereas in EVIS, you need not worry. It is all automatic inbuilt. As Prithvi Alagari was selling, what happens there, the number of steps are less here, number of steps are more actually, as far as costing is concerned actually. So by then, what happens? We'll now meet tomorrow and then we'll now start data migration. We are going to begin data migration tomorrow. Bye now.
Yeah. Thanks, Rana. Bye.